Destiny 2's bullshit has apparently gone mainstream, following in the footsteps of Battlefront 2, at least according to a news article on CNBC, which is about as mainstream as we're going to get on this channel. As reported by the news outlet, an analyst is saying that Destiny 2 is struggling because gamers are unhappy about the microtransactions, which, if true in any sort of sense... According to the analyst Cowan, the player hemorrhaging that Destiny 2's experienced since launch is gonna hurt Activision's add-on revenue, which boo-hoo for them. Doug Cruett says, while Call of Duty WW2 clearly had a great holiday, which likely sets up strong franchise live services revenue in 2018, blah, Destiny 2 is struggling right now, with player engagement appearing to be on the wane. As if that doesn't sound bad enough, the entire note that was written to the clients was called Destiny is not in a good place. The note also mentions that several Destiny live streamers are reducing the content that they're going to be showing. In fact, viewership of the game on Twitch is at what they call a franchise low, with 4,000 to 7,000 viewers on Friday afternoons. The original Destiny got 14,000 to 17,000 for comparison. I can hardly say I'm surprised. I gave Destiny 2 an 8 out of 10 when it launched, and then before the year was out, it ended up on my shittiest games of 2017 list. Between the pair of them, Activision and Bungie systematically dismantled any goodwill that game earns, with what started as weeks but became months of lies and bullshit and broken updates, and a predictable cycle of dicking over the audience and then insincerely apologising for it after the audience figured out the dickery. That's just the way I'd put it, though. I'm not a professional analyst. So the professional analyst has pointed out four reasons why Destiny 2 is in the shitter. Number one, design decisions were made that have made D2 a less engaging and less distinctive game than D1 in particular. Key aspects of the D2 endgame feel neutered compared to D1. Microtransaction implementation, while not nearly as problematic as in Star Wars Battlefront 2, has still been a source of player unhappiness. Bungie's apparent urgency in responding to player feedback has been disappointing. You don't say. Until recently, Bungie did a poor job communicating. You don't say! Its roadmap going forward, particularly compared to the more open stance of many other live service games, you don't say. Simply put, the analysis does not look good. It continues to say we do think Bungie still has some opportunity to fix the game's problems, but they note they're not sure that Bungie's got the ability to pull it off at this point. The analysis also name drops The Division from Ubisoft and Warframe as potential competition, and considering Warframe is basically Destiny but good, I'm glad to see it get a name drop here. So it's taken a lot longer than it did with Battlefront 2, but news about the unease and unhappiness with Destiny 2's community has started to bleed over into more mainstream news channels, which suggests that mainstream news channels have started to cotton on to the fact that these are pretty hot stories when you think about it, which in turn has a knock-on effect of making publishers a lot more scared to fuck about. I mean, let's go back to the Ghost Recon Wildlands loot boxes that we talked about in an earlier video, shall we? I noted that their announcement of said loot boxes came across like somebody was pissing their pants at the idea of Battlefront 2's community lashing back at them. And if you reread that announcement, you see at the beginning they start off by talking about how generous they've been, how much they've given you, how grateful you should be. They don't use those exact words, but that first paragraph is like five whole portions of look how philanthropic we are. Now, I've said before, and I still believe, loot boxes, microtransactions, all that bollocks ain't going anywhere. It makes too much money to be thrown on the scrap heap because of some bad PR. But clearly, the AAA game industry misjudged how well it had conditioned its audience. And while there are still millions out there advocating for the devils, it's simply bullshit that all publicity is good publicity, and what we're looking at here right now is bad bad publicity for any game that wants to follow in the footsteps of the Activisions and the Electronic Artses of the world. At the very least, I'm going to delight in the cruelly bum-lick ways in which these microtransactions, DLCs, loot boxes, etc. are justified by companies from now on. The whole player choice and player freedom lines can only get less credible the more and more they're used. And courtesy of the most downvoted post in Reddit history, we know what happens when a corporate explanation doesn't do enough to explain anything. And I might love that more than anything. I mean, I keep being told that I'm fighting a losing battle. I get really fucking hateful emails from people saying, give up on the loot box thing, you're a piece of shit, let businesses be businesses because they've got to make all the money. And I know I've quote unquote lost to the quote unquote battle, but watching their PR tools dismantle in their hands, watching publishers have a tougher and tougher time cramming their bullshit down people's throats, well, it might just be a graze across Xerxes' cheek, but I'll fucking take it. And as for Destiny 2, I don't want you to think that I'm delighting in a game failing. I'm delighting in a very good game that was turned into a very bad experience failing. Because at this point, no matter what the game, no matter what the franchise, no matter what the intellectual property, even if it's something I adore down to the bone, I'd rather have nothing than a cheap, empty, hollow, greed-fueled facade. Which is one of the reasons why I'm so glad Konami seems to hate making video games. At least you only have to deal with their bollocks once a year now. Speaking of which, can't wait for Metal Gear Survive.